sign it is tackling the climate crisis at home and abroad.
President Biden is doing that by banning new oil and gas leasing on federal lands and ordering federal agencies to go green. The administration claims anyone who loses an energy industry job because of this can be retrained to do something else.
Coal plants have been closing over the last 20 years. So what President Biden wants to do is make sure those folks have better choices, that they have alternatives, that they can be the people who go to work to make the solar panels.
And close to home.
We're not going to ask people to go from the middle of Ohio or Pennsylvania and ship out to the coast to have solar jobs. You know, solar jobs will be everywhere.
On Capitol Hill today, lawmakers heard testimony from Biden's pick to be Energy Secretary Jennifer Granholm.
Having been the governor of Michigan when the automotive industry was on its knees, I understand what it's like to look into the eyes of men and women who have lost their jobs through no fault of their own.
To preemptively fight climate change, FEMA may soon redirect $10 billion to build seawalls and elevate homes in flood-prone areas, according to the New York Times.
Listen, when most people get up this morning when they got up this morning, they didn't look at it and say that their number one priority was climate. They probably looked at it as the virus. We need to keep the priority where it is.
But the White House tells Fox FEMA can handle COVID-19 and climate change with this, quote, getting the COVID-19 pandemic under control is a top priority for the president and this administration. While we are looking for opportunities to help communities become more resilient to floods and fires, that does not and will not involve limiting our ability to fight this pandemic. Any reporting to the contrary is simply misinformed. The White House COVID-19 response team is trying to accelerate vaccine distribution, but supplies remain tight.
Now, we do not keep a stockpile of a large number of vaccines. We keep a 2 to 3 day supply as a practice just to account for variation in manufacturing production. That's it. The rest moves out to states.
President Biden sees COVID-19 and climate change as matters of life and death.
It's not just the pandemic that keeps people inside. It's poor air quality. Multiple studies have shown that air pollution is associated with an increased risk of death from COVID-19.
But the White House knows that executive orders only affecting this country are not going to fix climate change. The climate czar, John Kerry, admitted today that because 90% of the world's emissions come from other countries, even if the U.S. got down to zero emissions tomorrow, the problem still isn't solved. At the White House, Peter Doocy, Fox News.
Peter Doocy, thank you so much for that update. Joining us now this morning on News Now from Fox, everybody, is Heather McTeer Toney. She is a climate justice liaison with the Environmental Defense Fund. Good morning. Thank you so much for joining us and helping break this all down for our viewers. So we're hearing a lot of pushback from GOP members, and their main concern is the loss of jobs. What is your response to the policies that President Joe Biden has already signed?
Well, good morning. And I will say that is the number one focus of this entire climate environmental action work that was done, the executive orders. It's a focus on jobs. President Biden is coming through with his promises in the midst of pandemic and in the midst of crisis and emergency in this country. He's focusing on the climate crisis to tie all of this together. So it's really important to understand that as he's adjusting to working through this COVID pandemic that is hitting all of us, at the same time, he's recognizing that we must take bold, transformative action to get people back to work and to deal with the climate crisis. So it's really intuitive of him, and at the same time puts people to work, putting our country back on track to be leaders in climate. I couldn't be more excited about it.
So I worked in Texas for 5 years, and I had to cover the Keystone XL pipeline extensively. That was one of the president's first actions in office, essentially blocking a permit for the construction to continue. The outrage, especially from states like Wisconsin lawmakers and others to it, it's been very vocal. What do you want to say to those people?
You know, I think we have to really step back and focus on what this president is trying to do in the status that our country is in right now. We are truly suffering. American families are home and they are sick and they are dealing with the crisis of coronavirus. People are out of work, and the inequity and injustice that has been prevalent in this country over the past 4 years, particularly, has really driven us to a point where we have to focus on getting our country on track. And so what I say is that this is a way to tie all of those things together. We did a poll at the Environmental Defense Fund Action, and it showed that there is strong bipartisan support for all of the agencies coming together and working on climate as a way to solve not only the climate crisis, but to put people back to work, to deal with the inequities of our country. So, you know, I say there actually is quite a bit of bipartisan support. There is quite a bit of just desire for folks in our country to get to work, to do the things that we know families know how to do. And we have to support him on this.
Do we think that President Biden campaigned on these items, or do you think the climate change or policies have been shocking to most Americans?
Well, most Americans do understand that our climate is constantly changing and that we are in a climate crisis. This is a climate emergency. At the same time, we're trying to deal with coronavirus and our children at home from virtual school and us needing to work. So recognizing that President Biden can pull all of these things together and deal with the climate crisis as a way to address these problems is giving American families hope. It's telling us that we can do this. We can put people back to work getting clean energy jobs. And some of the things that happened in the executive order are showing that. So for example, there's an interagency working group specifically for energy communities. That's coal places, coal country, coal-fired power plants that are transforming their energy sources. There's a special group that the president has put together to say, we need to address this from all agencies. There's a whole of government approach that he is putting in place through the Domestic Climate Policy Council, where every single agency within the federal government will be addressing climate in some way. So whether it's the Department of Education, Department of Treasury, or the Department of the Interior, everybody will be on the same page. We're using an all of government approach to this, and there's strong support for that. So it's important for everybody to understand that this is a way for us to address the racial inequity in our country, put people back to work, and be the example that we know that our country can be.
For the president's critics who say for the first time in decades we were energy dependent and the president's actions are now an assault on the oil and gas industry, what would you say to those people?
Well, you know, that's not necessarily what this president is focused on. This president is focused on making sure that all Americans, and he's been very clear about that, that he's going to be the president for all Americans, and he's the president for all Americans to help us to get through this crisis. And there's no better president that could do that than President Joe Biden. He has already established that for those who are concerned in these spaces, that we are addressing them through multiple layers within the federal government. We're also looking at ways that we are transforming our space to 100% clean energy and even transforming some of the existing energy sources so that people are put back to work. You know, there's no doubt about it. There's no question. We're following the science. He's put the science number one, and that's another thing that he did within the executive orders. He's saying we have to follow the science on the climate crisis, and the science is telling us that we absolutely must move to clean energy sources, and we can be a leader in doing that. And here's the thing. In the executive orders, he says that the United States government is going to be the leader on that. What does that mean? It means the United States government is going to be the one that's purchasing, that's buying, that's looking for American-made products, that's ensuring that these dollars are going to the taxpayers in American cities and towns all across this country. So it's mayors, governors, church members, everybody is going to be able to benefit in multiple ways, and there's strong bipartisan support for that. I do think, though, now it's our turn. That's what folks like the Environmental Defense Fund, Moms Clean Air Force, that's what we're doing, because President Biden can't do this by himself. It's going to take not only an all of government approach, but all of our communities to understand that we have a role to play in this. And he's depending on us just like we're depending on him. And we can do this together.
Are there any other climate change orders you would like to see in the coming days? A lot of people say the president's first 100 days in office are going to set the tone for the rest of his term.
Well, he has done more than any American president has done on climate change. He's made good on his promises, and he has set out a strong plan of advocacy for climate change and underlying it with environmental justice. And that is so important. 2020 was an extremely difficult year for minority communities and for our country in a reckoning of what racial injustice has done to our country. And we saw it plain and simple in January of this year. But this president is intent on making sure that we're addressing those inequities and that we're addressing them through the climate crisis as well. It's very important that environmental justice, and there is an interagency working group for environmental justice, is an underlying foundational element of every part of the federal government. And he's made good on his promise with that. So as a mom, as an activist, as a leader, as a Southerner, it makes me feel comfortable. It makes me feel good to know that this president is focusing on all of government, all of us, and that we can make this transformational change with what he's outlined. He's really doing some bold action that we can all get behind.
Yeah, speaking about some of those actions, we've already mentioned the Keystone XL pipeline decision. We rejoined the Paris Climate Agreement, and the now president had previously said he'd replace the federal government's roughly 645,000 vehicles with an all-electric federal vehicle fleet. So again, do you just think that this is not necessarily growing pains, but obviously the recent change in administration, and some people are just so resistant to change, they just don't like change, and it's just going to take a little while for more people to get on board?
I think a lot of folks have gotten on board already. This past election showed us that there was a clear mandate to act on climate. When we look at the major movements that are focused on climate, they include young people. They include not just major green groups and organizations, but environmental justice groups, faith-based groups. So there is a multitude and a very diverse group of people across this country that find we have commonality when it comes to wanting to make sure that we all have clean air and we have clean water and that we can function without being poisoned in our own backyards. We can all agree upon those things. And so I think that there is not so much as growing pains as understanding that even though we're in the midst of a climate crisis, there is hope. I have a 15-year-old and a four-year-old at home. And I want to make sure that they are growing into an environment where they not only don't have to worry about whether or not the air they're breathing is poisonous, but that they have jobs in a clean economy, that they have career paths and opportunities in technology and innovation. And that's what this administration is setting us up for the future. So this is really a good way for us to look 20, 30 years down the road to make sure that not only are we secure in our climate future and moving to 100% clean energy, but that our children have a focus and jobs and something that they can be proud of as they continue this fight.
All right, Heather McTeer Toney with the Environmental Defense Fund, thank you so much for joining us live this morning right here on News Now from Fox.
Thank you.
All right, everyone, we are taking a live look at the White House and our nation's capital.